This is that test. And with the enemy now only 100 feet away, it's the last chance for Adam and his army to get their solar ray to work.
All right, soldiers, you're doing a fantastic job. I'd like everyone to take their mirrors off the target briefly and take a deep breath with me. Inhale. Exhale. On the count of three, I want you all to aim your beams at that black sun and keep them as steady as possible. Are you ready? We are doing this for Syracuse in 3, 2, 1. Aim on that black sun. Hold it steady. Find your beam. Keep it centered on that sail. That's it. That's twice as bright as before.
Twice as bright. But to ignite the sail, the focal point will have to reach 410 degrees Fahrenheit. And with the black sun at 230 degrees, that's a long way off.
Look, he's taunting you. We are giving this every possible effort. This is the last chance we have to catch this thing on fire. Oh! Oh no, he's lobbing flaming tennis balls at us. Keep those mirrors on the sail. Ooh, he just took out one of your great cameramen. Are you gonna stand for that? Keep those mirrors focused on the sail.
The tennis balls are flying, and the beams are focused on the sail. But while 280 degrees is impressive, it's still 130 off a sail ignition.
Okay, Adam, I figure that if this was a real war, you just lost, because I got a whole bunch of you guys, and you didn't get one of me.
I think you're right. Why don't you gear down and come on in? I think we got to call this one.
Yep, after over an hour of beaming the sun's rays onto the boat, our 500 soldiers have earned themselves an honorable discharge.
1, 2, 3.
You hear that?
I was actually kind of disappointed we didn't set the boat on fire. We've got plenty of sun, we got plenty of mirrors to do the trick. But here's the thing. MythBusters is about experimentation. It's not about demonstration. And when I was in the middle of this experiment out on that boat with all those mirrors shining in my face, I realized something really important. And that is that they were actually quite distracting and blinding, even painful. And that right there may be the grain of truth at the heart of this myth. Good old Archimedes may not have come up with this trick in order to set a ship on fire, but rather to distract and disorient invading armies. And that says something really important about the nature of experimentation. When we experiment, when we try things and we fail, we start to ask why. And that's when we learn.
Well,